광주 문제는 소설가로서 나에게 영향이 강했어요. 이름도 없고 주변적으로 머물러 있던 사람의 목소리가 역사 속에 투영이 됐을 때 저는 그 역사나 어떤 사회의 활동이 그 빛을 발한다고 생각을 해요. 여성이기 때문에 드러나는 현실이 있고 여성적 세계관을 제가 가지고 있기 때문에 포착되는 현실의 지대와 언어적 그 수준이 있다고 생각을 해요.
Most of Chaeyun's novels are formed by memories made of fragmental thoughts. The formless but vague images stay with the characters in the novels and the readers. That is why Chaeyun's novels pierce through pains in daily lives, becoming a ray of light in their inner darkness, despite the low tone in her pieces.
In 1996, a Korean film attracted a lot of attention in the film industry. It was the movie A Petal. Not only did it get a lot of response in Korea, but it also swept awards and film festivals in Rotterdam, Bangkok, and the Asia Pacific. The original work of this film is There a Petal Falls in Silence by the female author Chaeyun.
영화 장르가 가지고 있는 특성상 어떤 영화건 광주를 다루는 영화가 있으면 그것이 어떻게 얘기하면 좋을까요? 어떤 대중에게 알리고 망각 속에서 다시 한번 그 사건을 일깨울 수 있는 굉장히 좋은 기회가 된다고 생각을 했는데 그때의 그 제안이 들어왔습니다.
The Gwangju Citizens Democratic Movement was the most tragic among many historical events in the 1980s. It was a movement for democracy against the military dictatorship, a bruised memory that ended with more than 1,000 casualties in 10 days. The movie A Petal, for the first time in Korean film history, describes this event in full. It centers on a 15-year-old girl who became a mental patient. She was at the scene of the Gwangju Citizens Democratic Movement who ran away from her dying mother. But that pain is not only hers.
그 작품은 저 같은 사람을 위해서 쓰여졌어요. 무슨 얘기인가 하면 광주를 직접 경험하지 않은 대한민국의 굉장히 많은 사람들이죠. 실제 직접 현장에서 경험한 사람보다는 그렇지 않은 사람이 많습니다. 그런 사람에게 도대체 무엇일까? 그 여파를 알려주려고 했기 때문에 그 노래는 조금은 돌림 노래식으로 그 구성이 되어 있습니다.
말 The girl kept the memories and the painful grief that she wanted to forget all to herself. Through this girl, Chaeyun alters her shameful memories into spring-like energy of splendid petals. This piece is her literary debut piece. Her literature does not stop in reviving situations. Instead of treating the situations lightly before accepting or refusing them, she passionately tries to understand and relate to them. She has written novels since she was small, but started her life as a critic first. After 10 years of working as a critic and realizing she could no longer hide her inner thoughts, she made her literary debut in a state of mind of jumping off a cliff. Engaging in creative writing after her debut, Chae-yoon was noticed by the literary world by presenting experimental short and medium-length pieces. This attention also came from abroad. The French literary world's interest due to her education in France was more intense. The conclusions that we willingly accepted were not acceptable to her. They were new problems. It was not enough to get attention from others. Chae-yoon translated Korean literary pieces, exposing Korean literature to the world. She was always interested in talking about supporting characters rather than the main characters. The Last of Hanako is about female alienation. The Gray Snowman is another main piece by her. Through stories about students involved in movements in the Gray Snowman, Chae-yoon became an issue for displaying a new view of making the supporting characters heroes instead of the main characters.
기본적으로는 우리가 너무 평범하게 생각을 하고 있고 한 번도 이상하지 않다고 생각한 우리의 타자와의 관계 양상이 얼마만큼 잘못된 것인가? 얼마만큼 부조리한 것인가를 드러내기 위해서 사실 그 이면을 한번 적나라하게 드러내면서 우리 삶이 약간 불안정해지기를 내가 원했죠. 불안정을 거치면서 다시 관계의 복원을 그 원했달까요?
By looking at the world through various views on human beings, Chae-yoon approaches us with her own story. It's been 15 years since she started as a novelist, but she's just beginning. She still keeps a sharp lookout on the world, dreaming of a new start.
Seseang을 사랑하고 한다는 걸 표현을 하고, 세상에서 사랑받고 있다는 걸 확인을 하고, 비록 한 명의 독자라 할지라도 뭐 계속 쓰는 일이죠. 뭐. 네.
최윤 emphasizes that instead of being experiments, novels are new attempts. Those attempts draw the numerous images of herself hidden inside her. Perhaps her act of writing is like a trip through a maze, trying to find herself. And our reading of her novels is a search in that maze, an unbearable pleasure.